to Riffle Lake. And once again, my name's David. I'm the ranger naturalist for Tennessee State Parks. And we decided, was out here boat riding and decided we would stop, myself and Cody and some of my coworkers, and decided we would stop and look at one of the biggest cypress trees that's easily accessible. This is just a huge old tree. Can't even begin to estimate the age on this tree. But a tree like this could easily be 500 years old, maybe 700 years old, could be older. The oldest cypress tree we had in Tennessee was at actually one of our state natural areas, Big Cypress Tree State Park. And it was actually struck by lightning and burned in the 70s, and even a lot bigger than this tree. But this is a really neat tree, so we thought we'd spend a moment here. Cody's exploring the bottom of the tree. And when you look at the tree, it's kind of got a really unusual shape. And just something I want to point out is, if you look around the bottom of the tree, you can see a variety of other plants and trees that are using the cypress as a base to grow. Now, the main ones are persimmon. We have several persimmon trees growing out of the bottom of the cypress. So, one, how would a persimmon seed get out here in the middle of the swamp in the water of the cypress tree? Well, raccoons. Favorite food of raccoons is persimmons. They swim out here, they may live in the tree. They poop on the bottom of the tree, and then the crevices and the big roots of these huge old trees provide a base for those persimmon trees to grow where they cannot grow in the water. Also, another tree growing here is a pawpaw. We have a pawpaw tree growing out of the bottom, same way, probably the raccoons ate. Here's another pawpaw. The raccoons ate the pawpaws and pooped out the seeds on the bottom of the tree. We also have a wild rose growing out of the bottom of the tree. So here in another couple of weeks, these trees will be covered with wild roses. Just kind of to give a view of how big this tree is, Cody and I are going to climb out, climb up in the tree. Now, I have to be fairly careful. It would be embarrassing to fall out of the tree and roll down into the water in the swamp. Not so much for Cody. In fact, I'm surprised Cody has not already been in the water, because she is a water dog. But just kind of thought I wanted to help give them some perspective of how big this tree is that we're looking at. There are some bigger trees on the lake, not many. And as you can see, this tree has multiple trunks that all come out of one big solid base. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 big major trunks coming out. You have a huge limb coming out to the left. If you look closely on that limb, you can see some air plants, air ferns, growing out of it. So poison ivy growing all up the side of the tree. Luckily, I'm not allergic to poison ivy. Poison ivy is fairly common out here. But as we were boat riding, I just looked over and saw this tree, even though I knew it was here. And I just thought, you know, this would be a great place just to spend a moment talking about the big cypress trees here. Once again, oh, Cody's in the water. He said, okay, I couldn't stand it. In the water she goes. She smelled something. But anyway, a great big old tree, one that was kind of easy to pull the boat up to and film and learn a little bit more about an individual tree as opposed to the whole forest of cypress trees here at the lake. But we are still back in Old Crane Town, for those that just watched the other historical video on Old Crane Town. So once again, one of my favorite parts of the lake to come into, just because of the remoteness of it, it's otherworldly feeling, and these big trees, as well as the history, is just one of the things that really make this part of the lake special. So when you get a chance, come and join us at Riffle Lake or any of our 56 state parks. You know, state parks are set up to preserve and protect our unique natural, cultural, historical areas of Tennessee. And this is a prime example of some of those things that we are protecting for future generations on these huge old cypress trees out here in the remote areas of Riffle Lake. Have a great day and join us for some other activities.